flame and the fire and the fury. Nice, nice. Burn them. Only fight whites with fire. Fire with fire. Chop him in half. Oh god, here we go again. Is anybody gonna die here? It's just gonna be a straight fucking walker ownage. I don't know. Just keep it tight. I'm just keeping it tight right now. Oh, there goes one of them. Should have known one of them would suck. Time to give me that. Give me the bow. Fuck him up. One. Oh, shit, I only have enough for one. Oh, nice. The bear saved us. Sick, nasty. Don't even think about it. Just don't even think about it. Crush your skull, bitch. You can't touch my bear. Oh, fuck. Gotta help him.
Oh god! Finn!
Oh fuck, it's Finn? Great. That's great. Should've known Finn would show up as a walker or a white, whatever. Damn, still got that fucking strength though. Fuck off, Finn! Fuck off, Finn! We should be pulling this out of the ground. Whatever. Time to burn his ass up. Night night. Sorry, Finn. Not sorry. You're already dead. Put you out of your misery. Well, alrighty then.
Did you know him?
Yep.
Maybe I'm wrong, but you keep looking at him.
He was my friend. His name was Finn. He was here because of me. I let him join when we left Castle Black.
That was his choice. It's not your fault.
Now his watch has ended.
Officially, even though technically it was already over the first time he died. But now it's officially over, right?
You fought
right.
Well for a crow.
I saved your life.
I wouldn't go that far. Although I admit you can fight. Maybe they did teach you something at Castle Black.
Is that your way of thanking me?
Maybe I was wrong about you. We'll see.
You stop questioning me, bruh.
Killing them, I don't mind. It's the burning that stays with you. You'll never forget that stench.
Did you see what they just did? They don't care about their own.
My sister has trained them well.
It's not that you don't care about your own. It's just if you don't burn them, they come back alive.
According to her.
They don't mourn their dead.
They've been trained to fight. Nothing else matters but that. They're more my sister's doing, not mine.
The whites grow bolder by the day. Ever since the wildling tribes went south with Mance Raider.
Are you all right? You don't look well.
It's nothing. I'm fine. I should return to the village. Fulgorn Vysenir.
Okay. I guess that means let's go
back.
Did
you not hear me? Fulgorin! Suna!
What?
Wait! Fulgorin Vysenir.
The hell? fuck is up with that guy?
You're losing control.
Wait, is she controlling all
of
them?
What was
that? The hell?
It's blood magic. The more she uses it, the weaker she becomes. And they can sense it. Elsara's a fool to keep taking these risks.
Is there some way to help her?
She is convinced her blood magic is the only way to protect the North Grove. That her warriors are the answer. But she can't control it. I worry about her. It's more dangerous than she knows. She was right about one thing, though. The Whites are growing bolder. And the worst is yet to come.
They're growing bolder because they got leaders, man. They got walkers. White walkers, man. Kinda hope we get to see one before this is over.
Now that my father's dead, there's no reason to stay. That's why he sent you, isn't it? To bring us back to Ironwrath. To crush our enemies south of the wall. And avenge his death.
We can't leave the North Grove.
And stay here to die. I'd rather live. I know what my father said. The North Grove can never be lost. But he wouldn't want us to die because of it.
Uh-huh. Okay. Well, I mean, unless we know what the North Grove is actually capable of, like, in the big picture.
Never trust a fucking wildling.
Your fault for tying her up, dude. Shouldn't have tied her ass up. She probably just went to go find her brother. It makes the most sense, right? Anyways, alright. Now we're in the cells. Who's gonna come visit us in the cells? And don't you dare tell me it's the coal boy. It probably is gonna be the coal boy. Now we're covered in coal. Huh. Somebody else here? Yui.
Oh, disgusting.
Don't you even dare try to make me take a shat in there. No thank you. When I fall in love, I fall down the rabbit hole. Down the rabbit hole.
Rats.
Oh, it's a rat hole.
They're everywhere in King's Landing.
Oh, you know it. Bunch of fucking rats, man.
Oh, looks fresh. Looks like they didn't make it to the block.
I'm actually really curious to see who is crying in the other cell. Is it Sarah or no, I wonder? Damn,
oh God.
Someone got their teeth knocked out.
There's a human teeth.
Yeah, it's okay. Someone probably just got punched really hard. It's not like they just yanked him out one at a time or anything, right? We don't know that. There's a torch there.
No way to get this alight.
Then I could burn this whole place to the fucking ground. Else. Burn this whole fucking place to the ground. I'll take it anyways. Maybe we could beat the hell out of somebody with it, huh? I would be okay with that. Anyway, let's see who's going on. What's
Jayla,
going on?
Please.
Shut it.
Please come here.
Is that somebody we know or no? Hello? Do I know you?
I wonder what she's done.
She doesn't look familiar. Hello. How's it going?
Hello. Excuse me.
What do you want? Can you get me out of here? Because if not, I don't want to know.
Hey, no talking.
Jayla, come over here.
Oh, don't you start again.
Why don't you come here for a moment? We can have a little chat about it.
Gods, woman, I said shut it. Or I will come in there, and you won't like what happens.
Well, what do you want, then? Well, tell me, please. I'll do anything. Just tell me. Bastard!
Huh, I wonder why she's even in
Before
there.
Before the day's over, they'll take us straight to the block. So don't give me that look.
Bitch, please.
You can leave the judgment to the Father, whatever gods you believe in.
I don't judge you. We've all done things we're not proud of.
Yeah. So shut your goddamn mouth.
A little baby boy. I think of the smell of his skin. His tuft of brown hair. There is nothing I wouldn't do. Nothing. Just to hold him again. That's what getting out of here means to me. What would you do in my place? I'll never see him again.
Do anything.
Your family needs you. Nothing else matters. I do whatever it takes to survive. Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes, bitch. Oh, here he comes.
Please. Please take me out of here!
Mira, making friends already, I see.
Be quick. We'll be coming back for her next. For your trouble.
This fucking guy. Can we beat him to death with that torch? I would love to do that. Just knock him out.
Oh, no, no.
Come on, you.
No! Please! Wait! No! Get off!
Shut
me!
Your fucking mouth!
They'll be here for you soon. You don't have much time.
Yeah, suck it, bitch.
I've come to talk.
What's the point if I'm gonna die?
I've come to make you an offer.
Oh god, you're gonna make me an offer, okay.
I was thinking about what you said. And I've come to the conclusion you're right.
Always.
Lad will likely ruin every forest under his control.
Because he's
only
an asshole.
Foresters know how to really work ironwood. That's useful. And then I realized there's something much more valuable than your knowledge of trees, Mira. Your name.
Oh shit, he wants to marry her?
I want you as my wife.
God damn it.
Your wife? Have you lost your mind?
Not at all. This makes a lot of sense for both of us. I want Ironroth, and you're going to give it to me. It may not be the grandest castle in Westeros, but it's a start.
Marrying me won't help you get Ironroth. The title belongs to my brother. He's the rightful lord.
I am well aware of the king's law, Mira. You think I haven't thought about that?
He thinks Lud's gonna win still.
Two of your brothers are already dead. That idiot Lud will take care of the rest.
We'll see about that.
One way or another. And it won't take me long to get rid of the harebrained fool myself. I'm sorry, Mira. None of your family will survive. Ironroth will fall to you. And through marriage, it will become mine. A hold fast in the north can
I'll
only
kill you
help
in your sleep.
My ambitions.
Until I cut your throat in your sleep.
Doubtless you'd try, given half the chance. But you won't be. It's fitting our betrothal begins in a cell. I'd say it's a perfect symbol for the rest of your life.
You plan to keep me locked up?
Well, perhaps not literally. If you play your part and produce my heirs.
God, we got one of these fuck faces.
The murder of a Lannister guard can't go unpunished. But I can get you out of here, Mira.
We're gonna have to throw the kid under the bus, though, aren't you?
Boy takes your
yep,
place
I knew it.
Tom!
All you have to do is agree to marry me.
Nope.
You'll give
fuck
up
you,
your
buddy.
Power. You'll give up. Your ancestral
what if
home.
I say no? Is Mira just die
alive.
If I say no? I kind of want to know.
So, Mira, what do you say?
I say, fuck you, buddy. Never
you
be yours.
You will never have Ironroth, and you will never have me.
What? You fool.
I'd rather die.
Oh. That's right.
Fine.
Be as mad as you want, bitch.
Have it your way.
Who's the fool? You ain't gonna get what you want, because I ain't gonna get what I want. So fuck you, buddy. So is Mira actually gonna die right now, or I don't know. But fuck that. I wasn't about to agree to that no matter what. Fuck that shit. Fuck that shit. Alright, anyway, what do we got now?
She won't get far. Not out here.
Let me go!
I already caught her.
Sylvie!
She probably just went to see her brother. Jeez.
He's my brother! I wasn't finished!
When you're finished here, come see me. There's something I must show you.
I don't trust these people, Garrett.
Which was why I had to see Cotter. He's not well.
And he won't live much longer.
I thought he was getting help.
Whatever they've done, it hasn't worked. There's nothing that will save him now. Which is why I needed to do something for me.
Which is?
I didn't want him to suffer anymore, Garrett. Just to ease his pain, but that's when they found me.
The Nightshade.
I need you to be the one to end his suffering.
What?
It's our way, Garrett. You have to feed it to him. I'm trusting you to do this, Garrett. You're the only one who can.
He did say go ahead and do it and take care of Sylvie.
You can trust me. I'll do the right thing.
Thank you, Garrett. He's in so much pain.
The only problem is, I think what they're gonna do to him is they're gonna make him one of these guard people that she's fucking brainwashing or whatever with her blood magic. But we'll see. Let's see what she's got. Let's see what she wants to talk to us about before I make that decision. Let's find out. Quit staring at me, dude. I'm here to talk to the girl. She invited me. So quit fucking staring at me like that. Hello? Oh, shit. They're about to just burn his ass to death right now or something?
I did everything within my power to help your friend. But I'm afraid it's too late. Nothing can save him now.
Sylvie told me.
Nightshade? What are you going to do with that? You realize it's deadly. And has no place in here.
I promised Sylvie I'd give it to him. To end his suffering.
I don't know what that wildling told you. But that will kill him and taint his blood.
What's the difference between him dying that way and dying another way, huh? What's the difference? What's the fucking difference?
Garrett. Garrett. Is that you? It's me, Cotter. I'm here.
Where's Sylvie?
I want to see her.
Where is she? Did something happen to her?
Don't worry. She's right outside. She sent me to help you.
I thought they took her away.
Remember your promise, Garrett.
You said you'd leave me behind.
To help Sylvie.
Cotter! Oh, I can't bear it anymore!
He's been incredibly brave. A lesser man would have died days ago. But I suppose you already knew that about him.
You said you'd help him.
I wish I could. But I'm afraid it's too late for that now. But you can still use his death to give his life meaning. This was always intended for my father. It's a sacred symbol of the power of the North Grove. Forged from iron. The handle made with ironwood from this very tree. In my father's absence, you speak for House Forrester. It seems only right that you should have this now. You're here for a reason, Garrett. It's no accident they sent you.
I'm honored. Thank you.
It's well deserved.
Okay, but what the fuck are you giving it to me for? To kill him with, or what?
Your friend is dying. But his life is too valuable to waste.
So what do
you... Give me his heart. His
beating heart. You're gonna make him one of your fucking soldiers.
And his death can have meaning. We can use it for a greater purpose, Garrett. An ancient ritual to help harness the power of the North Grove.
But...
We must do this, Garrett. I fear what might happen if we don't.
Why me? Can't you do it yourself?
Not alone. I'm far too weak. You saw what happened after the fight. My warriors, they're pulling away. Please, I need you to do this. For me, for the North Grove.
I'm ready. Gareth. Any longer.
So what, we either nightshade him or we
and
stab
his
him.
Suffering. Use his life to make us strong, Garrett.
Here's the choice.
Give him that poison, and his blood will be useless. Let us use
seems
his blood
wrong
to give
use
us
him
strength.
For blood magic. It seems
out
to me
there, you saw what's
that
possible.
You should never.
That was only
fucking
the beginning.
Use blood magic. It doesn't seem like a good idea.
I'm sorry. But I can't do it. Cotter's my friend. I wouldn't be here if not for him. And I have to respect what Sylvie asked me to do.
Then so be it.
So be it? That's it? You're not even mad? She's not even mad. Well then. Sorry, dude. You're dead. I mean, you were gonna die anyways. They're all turning on her one at a time because she can't control them all at once.
We must burn the body.
I just wonder, like, what else she could do with her power. I don't know, man. It's weird. Like, she has power, clearly, or some way to harness some power. But, like, what is it going to be useful for? I don't understand. But her brother said she was, like, getting screwed over by it, so I don't want to get her
your
screwed over.
Your fighters are in place.
Oh, that's right.
Keep the White Hills calm.
That's right.
As soon as they're all seated, give the signal.
We're about to ambush these bitches. I almost forgot,
remember,
man. I got so
no
sidetracked for a minute there.
No matter how much they might provoke you, we must let them think they've won.
Yes, yes. I got it.
That's them. Here we go.
Here we go! All right, must tell them that they won. Oh, goddammit, he brought Gwyn.
Clever. Send the girl first. Don't let her play with your head, little brother.
Lady Forrester. My apologies for arriving unannounced. I was hoping I might have a word in private with Asher.
After you, my lady. What do you want?
I think we can agree these are not ideal circumstances.
Uh-huh.
Agreed.
But these are the circumstances we find ourselves in. I know how you must feel, Asher. What your family has suffered, it's unimaginable. Which is why the bloodshed must stop.
I agreed to your father's terms, didn't I?
You did. But I know you, Asher. You're not the one to roll over so easily. You don't like being pushed into a corner. It's not in your nature.
Things are different now. I'm different now. But you have nothing to worry about.
You were always a terrible liar. You have to understand. I've risked everything to bring peace between our houses. To meet with Roderick in secret. To tell him of the traitor within these very walls. To make sure no harm came to Ryan as our ward. All while persuading my father the bloodshed would end if we were to wed. I have no ulterior motive, no hidden agenda. Just peace, once and for all.
I'm sorry, but I don't trust your father. He ordered the ambush. He'd just as soon slit my throat as see us wed.
That was before. My father would never betray my trust. Truth be told, my father's scared of you.
He should be.
With Roderick, he knew who and what he was dealing with. But you, he thinks you're dangerous. You proved as much when you attacked his men.
They came after us.
I know. And that's all in the past now, I promise. We can make this work, Asha. This is our one chance.
Never be blinded by the booty, man.
Control the future of our house.
Never be blinded by the booty.
Just promise me, when my father and brother walk through that door, nothing will happen that could threaten that future. Our future. I need your assurance. Nothing will happen.
I promise.
I'm just gonna go ahead and tell her, because I don't give a fuck about her.
Thank you, Asha. I knew I could trust you.
I'm gonna lie to your face.
Sorry to intrude, my lord.
End of story.
But Lady Forrester is in need of your help.
We do nothing.
Of course.
To give away the plan.
I should go.
Nothing.
Thank you, Asha.
We do nothing to give away the plan.
What help does my mother need?
Sorry, my lord, it's all that came to mind. But we have everything in place.
Sick.
How should we proceed?
Ambush is still on.
Ready the men.
Consider it done, my lord.
Hell yeah, bitch. We don't go back. No, sorry, Bob. Keep everybody ready. I just want to see how this goes down. More than anything, I'm just curious, okay? Consider me bloodthirsty all you want, but I want to see what happens. I mean, I know the outcome of events is slightly different, but it's not going to change that much, right?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry it's come to this, but at least it's done.
Where's my son?
Right to it, then.
Where is Ryan? Ryan!
Mother!
There you go. Finally.
Oh, my baby. Oh, my baby.
All right, now slaughter them all.
Slumbering.
Oh,
coming
what?
Back when we've hammered out the details of your surrender.
That's jacked up, man.
Lord Whitehill.
Asher. Now, who'd ever have imagined this? You welcoming me into your hall to drink your wine and call me father.
All right, remember, we got to play along, so whatever I say is playing along. Here we go.
I thought I'd see the last of you when Gregor shipped you off to the other side of the bloody world.
You honor us, Lord Whitehill, with your presence. And with this union.
Honor you? I didn't take you for an arse-licker, Forrester.
Father, don't bicker. Asher's showing you respect.
Somehow I doubt it.
Doesn't matter
what
I say.
Would you like to sit down, Lord
Whitehill? He's gonna be a dickbag no matter what I say.
Get us something to eat! I'm bloody starving!
We thought you'd like to sit here, Lord Whitehill.
I'll sit there. Thank you very much. In the Lord's chair. It's not like your father wanted your worthless arse, is it?
Just let him have
our
everything.
Our hall is yours, Lord Whitehill.
Make yourself comfortable.
Of course it's my bloody hall!
Lull him into a false...
Are ready to give it over? Your false smiles don't fool me, Forrester.
Calm down, Father. Asha's just showing you the respect you deserve.
Yeah, bitch. He's gonna be skeptical about everything anyways. Doesn't even matter. You could sass him, or you could agree with him, or you can do whatever you want, but he's gonna be a little bitch either way.
Rather odd that Talia's not here, isn't it? And your bannermen look a little tense. What are you playing at, Forrester?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Something's not right. I can feel it.
You're paranoid, Lord. It's just your imagination.
I know what I see. Don't play games with me, Forrester. See? That's the trouble with you, Forresters. No manners. At least Roderick had enough decency to carry a proper conversation. Maybe I should have kept him alive after all. I knew...
I don't know. I just fucking said to start this shit. That probably wasn't a good time to start it, but here we go. Fuck it. Oh no. Save him, girl. Nice. Aw, man. Wait. Oh, we gotta fight Griff first. Griff's about to get fucked. Griff can't fight for shit. He got beat down by a fucking... By a fucking cripple. Bring it. Bring it. White Hill will not escape me, bitch. You will not escape me, bitch. Oh, fucking Griff. Get out of here, fucker. Gwyn, where did Gwyn go? Shook him? You don't want none. Oh, you think you can headbutt? You think you can headbutt with the best of them? No fourthborn can handle a secondborn, bitch. Filthy fourthborn! Oh, to the flames with you, bitch. To the flames with you. Get back in there. Or that. Or that. And there goes Griff.
Run out of words, Griff. That must be a first.
Sucks to be you, dude. Oh, fuck. Gwyn stabbed me.
Gwyn!
It could have been so different. But you destroyed everything.
I destroyed everything? I destroyed everything. Alright, cool. Damn it. And she stabbed us just enough to not be able to chase down Fat Ass. Fat Ass got away, didn't he? God damn it. Fat Ass got away. God damn it. Did I fail at that or what, man? Could I have gotten him? Should I have waited longer? I don't know, man. I don't know. If I would have waited longer, would I have failed to call the ambush on? I don't know, man. I might have to, like, try this again or look up some other playthroughs of this just to see what could happen differently.
They're trying to kill us! Kill them all! Kill the fucking Foresters!
Okay, he didn't get away yet. He's not gone yet.
We can't fight that many! We're doomed! If they breach the gate, we're done for! We can't fight the entire White Hill army!
Well, then we gotta fucking kill all these bastards first. Do it.
My lord, your wound. Get them to safety.
Of course.
I won't abandon you, not again.
Please, mother.
Man. This is all bad. Here we go, though. Fucking Gwyn. Fuck you. More? Master, anybody else want some?
Our lord is here! Answer your lord!
He's here!
Damn right he's here. Kill some bitches. Damn, just killing villagers, man. That's not cool.
My lord, your command!
Defend the gate.
We have to retake the gate! Retake the gate!
Small folk is not my problem right now. If we don't take the gate, then we're fucked. Sorry, small folk. You are not going to be able to be saved.
This is the war you promised, Master Rossi.
It's not over yet.
To Asher!
Bring it. Go! Damn, dude. This is some shit right here. Get some, bitch. Gotta get the Lud. Gotta get the Lud. Gotta get the Lud. Choke him. And you're dead. Gotta get the Lud. Gotta get the Lud. Be scared, fat boy. Aw, shit. Here it goes. Shields! Shit. Really? Oh. That was my bad. I was about to say. I didn't even realize I was supposed to press something. That was my bad. Let's try that again, shall we? I didn't even see a button to press. I was supposed to press up. I didn't even see that. It happened so fast.
The cowards have us pinned.
Check it.
Good idea, Westerosi. Let's give those fuckers a welcome to remember.
Blow those bitches up. Blow those bitches up. Get out of here. Night night. Ah, yes. Fat ass is down. Get him. Get him. Aha. He's gonna stop us. Yep, this fucking guy, of course.
Asher Forrester. You've come this a long way guy. To die.
You don't even have a name. That's how much you don't matter, sir. You're just the douche who keeps little kids captive, and then you get wrecked, bitch. Get some. Oh. Still want to keep that helmet on?
Let's see you live up to your reputation.
Alright. Bring it, ho. Get some. Get some.
Rally to your lord.
Man. Man. These fucking Essos guys aren't helping too much. Come on, guys. Fuck this guy. Get wrecked, bitch. God damn. Come on, Asher. Come on, Asher. Nah, man. Mash the button. Nope, not burning. Not gonna happen. Not gonna happen. Nice. Oh, nice. Oh, the mom. No, did not expect the mom to go down like that. Not like that. Oh. Are you serious? Well, I mean, this guy's gonna be dead, but is Asher and his mom about to go? Oh my fucking god, right now. Oh, that guy's fucking dead as hell. Yeah, you're definitely dead, sir. Fuck your shit. Damn, that's fucking. Oh, fucking harsh. Damn, dude. You're telling me it wouldn't even have mattered if I had Roderick or Asher win? Man. Or is Roderick... I mean, is Asher alive after that? I mean, he got stabbed in the side.
My son.
Well, there goes the mom. That's it, huh? That's it. That's just it. Oh, fuck. I pressed the wrong button, I think. I don't know if it would have mattered, actually. Nice. Oh, man. This sucks. Fucking Game of Thrones and it's bullshit where nobody survives. God damn it. You're dead. Yep. Super fucked, dude. Yep. I would say they're all gonna die. Whitehill. I'm just gonna walk away. There's only one thing left to do, dude. If you take Whitehill out...
I am from ice.
And... Oh, shit. Lord, motherfucking Roiland.
Get you out of here. I'll be damned if I let another lord die on my watch. Save yourself.
Huh.
You must survive, Asher. For the house. For all of us. Go! Now!
All right, there goes Roiland. Somehow this guy got out the front gates. And they all missed. Oh, shit. Well, the horse got away at least. Man. And that's... Is that going to be the it? Is that it? Or do we get an ending? We have to have an ending for everyone, right? That can't be it. We have to have an ending for everybody else. Like, that's a good ending for Asher, but we have to have an ending for Mira and for Garrett before this is over. It can't be over yet. Because, like, this is the last episode, so we have to have everybody leave off on a point that's considered an ending. So, come on. Who's next? And who? I mean, we still got to do both of them, right? Like, both of them don't have an ending yet. Yeah, okay, here we go. Back to the north. I did what you wanted, so you're welcome. Now what? Remember, we have to burn him, right? She's okay with this. She knows.
You did the right thing.
I did what I had to do.
He was your friend.
You burn him. All right, light him on fire. What are you gonna do? Why is the fire so blue around here? Is it just because of the snow, or is it just blue fire? I don't know. He's pretty damn blue, so it couldn't be just from the snow.
Your arrival okay. has changed everything.
So now what?
Even though we've been preparing for it all our lives, now we don't have much time. We were sent here for a reason, to protect the North Grove. Winter is coming, and we have a role to play in the war to come.
Our father never would have wanted us to stand by and see House Forrester fall. Not while we can still do something about it.
It's too late to reach Ironwrath. It may already be lost.
Gregor trusted you for a reason. You know defending House Forrester is the right thing to do.
You're the one they sent, Garrett. You should be the one to decide.
Stay here or march south. I think we should probably stay here, because we march back south. I don't know. I don't think either one is good, but I think we're just going to stay
here.
I will
respect Lord Gregor's dying words. The North Grove will never be lost while we breathe. We will defend it.
Don't even know what that really means, but we're going to do it anyways. So is that it for Garrett, or are we actually going to have like something happen? That wasn't that big of a choice. I mean, it was, but was it really? Probably won't even know till next season of Game of Thrones. Who knows? But we gotta have an ending for Mira as well, right?
In the name of the king, I hereby sentence you to death.
Yep. Here we go. Who's gonna intervene and let Mira not die? That's the question. Or will she? Guess we'll find out. Are we going to get some intervention here? That's the real question. I kind of hope we do, but who the hell would vouch for us at this point? I don't even know. Probably nobody, so Sarah's in the crowd. Go ahead. Kill me. See if I give a shit. See if I give two shits. Or one shit, for that matter. Or half a shit. Yeah, fuck you, buddy.
Bring forth the next prisoner.
Hope you don't mean me. Oh, you're gonna make me walk. Alright. Fine. What's up, dog? How you doing?
This young woman is accused of murdering a loyal servant of the king. Who here bears witness to her crimes?
Is he gonna spout out? Is the coal boy actually gonna fucking...
A murderer!
Killer! She's innocent!
A disgrace to her family name!
Yeah, you can't fucking... You can't break me, bitch.
In the sight of gods and men, and in the name of the king, I sentence you to die.
Shame!
Raven!
Killer!
If you have final words, speak them now.
She's innocent!
Iron from ice, bitch.
Iron from ice!
Yeah.
She's innocent! Oh, noble
killer!
Kneel.
Iron from ice, bitch. Someone's gonna intervene here, right? Just like with saving Asher, someone's gonna jump in here and fucking save us, right? Or is she just dead? I don't know. Just accept your fate. The coal boy or somebody's gonna do something, right? Somebody? Anybody? Anybody? Somebody? Here it comes! Wow! Really? Just nothing. Just nothing. Well then. Okay. I really thought there was gonna be something there. I mean, there probably could have been something there. But based on my choices, I probably fucked up. Wow. Mira dead. Damn. Okay. But now what? I gotta keep talking, because if I'm too quiet, this is probably gonna get marked for the stupid music, so... I guess this is just going to be how this ends, huh? Garrett is just going to point onward, save the North Grove, and blah, 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 blah. And that's going to be it, huh? That's going to be it. Yeah, I'm going to assume that this part's probably got the music copyright if I don't say anything. Because last time there was a lot of music and no talking. I didn't talk, and it got marked, so yeah. Is Sylvie going to at least be on my team? I guess it looks like she is. So now what? I don't know. Everyone freaking died, man. Well, I mean, not everyone. Asher's still alive, technically. But everybody else died, man. There's not even barely any Foresters left. Fucking dropping like Starks, man. I know, right? I know. Then again, not as many Starks are just dead as people think they are dead.
Forester. They were nothing but Stark loyalists. And the Starks are dead. Are you listening, Reek? Father wanted to make sure they'd bend the knee. And what
do
I...
like how it's going over my decisions.
A child, Lord. Ethan the Wise.
Only 6% people got Ethan the Wise. That's not very many.
As if I'd be
afraid. Wow, and only 30% of people chose Sir Roiland.
And I thought, this is going to be fun.
Huh. Okay.
Mira was so devoted when we first came to King's Landing. That day Cersei dragged her before the throne, Grandmother, I was actually worried for her. But she didn't have any trouble swearing loyalty to Joffrey right in front of me. Then she had the audacity to go behind my back with Tyrion when I clearly forbade it.
That's a lot of people.
And then that letter she forged to Elena Glenmore. as if I wouldn't find
only 24%
out.
Of people betrayed Marjorie.
I'll give her that.
Fuck Marjorie.
But I can't forgive that she used
only
me.
34% stole her shit,
and
too.
Now,
wow, nobody stole her shit either.
Her.
That's kind of weird.
Who knows what else Mira was
you
doing?
You and 9% people ran away. Everyone else saved
Grandmother,
the whole boy.
It makes me question if she was ever loyal to me at all.
32% did what you had to do.
I saw something of myself in Garrett Tuttle. I thought I could trust in him.
29% trusted John.
But I was wrong.
North Grove.
He gave me his word.
That's right.
That he'd stay true to the vows he'd made in the gods.
65% against your will.
Yet before her day was out, her brother was dead atop the wall.
70% killed Brit in self-defense.
I needed his sword at Craster's. I defended him to Frostfinger.
Down.
And it cost me. Whatever happened up there, a man of the watch doesn't run away.
Who should return then? But another Lord Forrester. Roderick.
70% refused to kiss Lord Whitehill's ring. That's a lot of people.
Chabbing out that Vorthborn's eye.
61% mutilated Griff's face.
And ruining Griff's little humiliation by climbing out of the mud again and again and again.
32% challenged Griff's claim to authority.
I was rather starting to like him. A shame he didn't last longer.
60% sacrificed Roderick's life, so Asher was the liver in most people's cases.
There was something about Asher Forrester. You would have liked him, Miss Sandai. He was rude and aggressive, mind you. But
14%
were
hostile with Daenerys. Yeah, because Daenerys is too hot to be hostile with, you know what I'm saying?
I needed
38% told Daenerys you need an army. So only 38% told her
why? He impressed me. He followed my every command, despite what it cost him with his companion. 44%
stopped Beska. Okay.
For that, he earned my help. And my
70% were rewarded with a chest of gold.
Loyalty.
Sick.
Friendship.
77%
respect.
Promised Sarah's key bastard secret. I should have just...
Nothing.
And 87 didn't tell Tarwick? Man, I should have told Tarwick.
In the end, Mira came to 62%
took punishment from Marjorie rather than
lie. So easily
I should
have
just fucking threw Sarah under the bus.
Herself.
She threw us under
but
the
instead,
bus. Fucking bitch.
What she did took grace.
65% pleaded
enough,
with Tyr-
you
Tom
landing with
to
your
break into the
intact.
Office. What, were we going to tell him
Mira
not to?
Mira proved that. But at so high a cost...
75% rejected Morgan's offer and accepted
I
death.
I could have told you this story wasn't going
41% double-crossed Gwyn and her
Roderick
family in the
dead,
halls.
His mother dead? His little pile of timber in 64% ruins?
64% sacrificed small folk over the gate. Okay.
That Bolton bastard let their upstart houses go to war, Father. I'm not unfamiliar with these foresters. Stubborn to the end. They were clever, I'll give them that, but far too sentimental. Ruled by emotion when they should have been smart. Instinctive, instead of shrewd. When will these northerners ever learn? The Starks are
the
dead.
The defense of House
the
Forrester, you chose Sir Roland as your sentinel for his passion. Ambushed Lutz's family to try to end the war, helped Cotter end his suffering, kept your integrity but lost Marjorie's favor, and stood up to Griff, regardless of consequence. And 34% fought with instinct and nobility. So I'm the same as the third of people, basically, who played this game. Interesting. Okay, well, I guess that's it, guys, right? Credits roll, and we call that a season of Game of Thrones? Maybe? Possibly? Probably? Do we get, like, a cliffhanger ending to be like, yo, here's... Oh, yep, maybe. Maybe. Maybe a little bit of a teaser for next season? Like, where Asher's gonna end up? Ooh, this could be good. This could be good. Let's see where he ends up. Brotherhood without banners? That's my first guess. Let's see if I'm right. Come on, lucky guess. Come on, lucky guess. Come on, lucky guess. Really? Nothing? Just... He fell off a horse and that's it? That's not a cliffhanger. That's not a cliffhanger.
My lord.
Oh, wait. The fuck?
We haven't much time.
How the fuck did he get out? The hell?
They may have won this battle, but they will not win the war.
How the fuck did he get out? And why is Talia with him? That's the other question I have. What the hell is she doing there? Anyway, she probably has Ryan, so we're good on that. That's what I figured. That seemed obvious to me. Okay. Okay. Ewan 60% told Marjorie the truth and were dismissed. Ewan 75% refused to marry Morgan. Damn, that's a lot of people who accepted Mira to die then. 39% gave Cotter a merciful death. I mean, everybody else picked blood magic? That's jacked up, man. Ewan 41% ambushed Lord Whitehill. You mean hella people gave in to Lord Whitehill? F that. F that. Ewan 51% stayed to defend the North Grove, so that's a 50-50 choice. Interesting. Okay, well. Okay, guys, that does it for Season 1 of Game of Thrones, a Telltale Game series. Wow, okay. What an interesting game. If I haven't said it enough times, I don't know how much I've actually said it, but I am a big Game of Thrones fan, like super huge. So even if this wasn't the greatest game, Telltale game ever made, I like it just for the simple fact that it gives me more Game of Thrones universe stuff with actual Game of Thrones characters mixed in, like people that we know. I should say, saying actual means nothing really, other than by that I mean people from the actual show. So having actual Cersei and Marjorie and Ramsay and Tyrion and freaking Jon Snow and Daenerys. I mean, who else do you want, really? And based on this part of the story that where this takes place, those are the characters you would expect to be in the show or in the game, and they're there. And the real voices of the people in the show are their voices, which is the best part, in my opinion. Anyway, okay, so I assume if there is a Season 2 of Game of Thrones, which I assume there will be, haven't actually looked it up to see if they're working on it right now and it's coming anytime soon, but based on that ending, there has to be, right? Too many people are left alive to call that a real ending. I mean, Asher lived, Ryan got away, Talia is with Asher, apparently Duncan's going to be involved somehow. Obviously, Garrett's still up there defending the North Grove, and who knows who else could be added into this? Will it always be about the Foresters if they do another one? Because if that's the case, I mean, you got Garrett, you got Ryan, you got Talia, you got Asher, but after that, you got nobody else left. Everybody else died, man. Anyway, I would hope that they throw at least one new character in, and I don't mean Ryan, because I think Ryan might get thrown into the next one since he's now separated from everybody else, but I feel like they should have another new character, like somebody who's in King's Landing or somebody who's in another big part of the world who can help out the Foresters. Anyways, whenever that happens, okay, that'll be cool. I don't know if I'll do it. We'll see. I mean, obviously, if it might be a long time from now when that gets released, and there's no guarantees that I, like I said, that I will do the next season. I guess it'll depend on your guys' request of doing it and my just schedule and all that and how it fits into what I'm working on at the time and all that good stuff that pretty much is going to dictate what happens here. So at this point in time, we'll just leave it here, and that's the end of the Game of Thrones Let's Play. Yay! I had fun. I really did, though. I mean, Telltale is really good at telling some good stories, so this was, like I said, it's probably not the best. In fact, I probably liked Walking Dead a bit more. But in this one, it was still pretty good. It was still pretty good. And it gave you the fucking futile feeling that freaking Game of Thrones always gives you when you're watching it. That no one is safe. Nobody's safe. Alright, I'm going to call that an episode. I'm going to call that a Let's Play for now. And as for other Telltale games, I probably won't be doing another one for some time, if ever. So I might do another one. I shouldn't say it like I'm not going to, but like, I don't have any other ones planned to do, so if I do end up doing another one, it'll be a surprise to me as much as you guys. And if you really want to see me do another one, request it, and maybe I'll do the next one. If I do another one, will be based on your guys' decision. We'll see, because there's plenty of other ones to choose from. I don't feel like listing them all here. You guys know them just as much as I do, I'm sure. All right, that's it. See you guys on another Let's Play. Hope you guys enjoyed, and of course, look forward to October. October's going to be good this year. Keep an eye out for it. See you guys later. Peace.